All right, I'd like to welcome everyone here today. We're going to go ahead and get started here in just 1 minute. I know it's a lot of us we're trying to cram in today, so if you have any space at all next to you and you can kind of squeeze in towards the middle, I know some of you are still saving seats and whatnot, but we want to try to get as many people in as we can. I appreciate your help with that. I want to draw your attention to an insert that you may have seen in your bulletin, especially for those of you members of Beltsville. If you're not, you're welcome to come join us on December the 31st. We are having, for the first time in our history, all three services of Beltsville under one roof. That will be taking place at the GC Auditorium from 10 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. There will be no service held here at this facility on December 31st. It will be a joint worship convocation from 10 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. And we'd love to have you all come out, be a part of this celebration as we celebrate what God has done in our church for the year of 2016. So mark your calendars for that. There's a map on the back to get you to the GC Auditorium, and we'd love to have you come out. But today, what we're most excited about is that the Beltsville Adventist School is doing our program for us today, and we're so excited that the school has come and that your children are here to share with us today, so I'm going to turn it over to them at this time.
Good morning and welcome to Beltsville Seventh-day Adventist Church. If you happen to be that one person that's visiting here today, we are so excited. Now, I know you're visiting from other churches, but if you're that one person that thought, what have I gotten myself into? We hope when you leave today that you think, wow, that was a great surprise for me. But thank you so much for coming, and thank you for loaning us your children, for all the support that you give to them and to us. Welcome.
Can we please bow our heads for prayer? We thank you, Lord, for this beautiful day. We thank you for all of the young people that you've entrusted to our care and all the work that they've put into preparing for today. We pray, Lord, that you will prepare our hearts and minds to receive the message you have for us this morning. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you.
We need to make an announcement. Someone has double parked. It is a gray or maybe a off-white Toyota Venza, Maryland plates 7BG5353, and I believe it's along the side here. People cannot get out. If I could have that car moved, we'd appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Please join me in singing hymn number 132, O Come All You Faithful.
Come ye, O come ye, to Bethlehem. Like the wise men, when we enter into the presence of Jesus, we humbly bow our lives in worship to our Savior and our King.
Bethlehem, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? For we have seen a star and have come to worship him." And when they saw Christ's child, they were overjoyed. As they entered into his presence, they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, incense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
Please join me in singing Joy to the World.
Every heart prepare him room.
On behalf of the students and staff of Beltsville Adventist School, I say thank you. Thank you for your faithful financial support and for praying for us. We have a special school because of you. Thank you. Please bow your head for prayer. Thank you, Lord, for all the blessings you have given to us. Please bless these offerings, and may they be used to tell others about you. In Jesus' name, amen.
We have another announcement. There is a Toyota van, Maryland license plate ABY5136. You're over blocking the field area, so people who are on the field cannot get out of that area. If we could have that van moved, it would facilitate things. Thank you.
Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever was heard. Tell me. The love that came gently that night in Bethlehem changed the world forever. This one who was prophesied by the ancients, proclaimed by the angels, praised by the shepherds, and pursued by wise men. He is Savior, Redeemer, Lord, and King. And the angel told Mary to call his name Jesus.
Haven't they been doing a wonderful job? Amen. We have amazing children at our school. We have an amazing school. It's so great to get together and celebrate this Christmas season of the year. And I'm just so thankful. I want to thank our teachers and our principal, Wendy Pega, for putting this program together. They've done a beautiful job. And I love seeing our young people up here. And parents, you should be proud of these children. Now, I did notice when I walked up here that everybody put their camera away. I'm a little disappointed by that. So I'm just going to have to take a selfie of myself with all of you in the background. Okay, I feel better now. Thank you for letting me do that. About 4 years ago, I did something that I probably won't do again as a parent. I loaded my family of five, my wife and three children, up in the car, and we drove 13 hours to Florida. Now, the problem with this decision was that the car only seated five people, which means my children were sitting three across in the back. And parents, some of you know exactly where this is going already. So with them seated so close to each other in the back, it wasn't long before we heard, Mom, Lila hit me. Mom, Noah's on my side. Mom, Bryn won't leave me alone. And it was just, you know, stop fighting, kids, stop. It's fine, we're almost there. We'll make it. But as you know, in the confined space of the car, no matter how much excitement there was about going to Disney World and 13 hours after we get to Florida, the drive kind of just consumed them, and it was just too difficult in that confined space. And as you know, as a parent, one of the challenges that we have is for our children to get along. We want nothing more for them to get along with each other. Now some of you were wise. You only had one child. You don't have this problem. So very smart. Good forethought. I wish I thought of that, but I didn't. So with three, one of the issues that you will always face, or if you have two, is to have your children get along with each other. And that's our desire as parents. That's our heart's desire. And it's interesting because I believe that's also our Heavenly Father's heart's desire, is that His children would get along with each other. One of the famous passages of this season of the year is when the angels appeared to the shepherds and they announced, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." And it is the longing of God for there to be peace on earth. Unfortunately, what we often see when we look around us in the world today is the opposite of that. We see conflict, we see division, we see people bickering and fighting with each other, and we don't see peace on earth. And we wonder, will we ever see peace on earth? And the good news of the Advent season, the season of the first coming of Jesus, is that it also points forward to the second Advent, the second coming of Jesus, when He will restore peace to this earth. And I don't know about you, but I long for that day. However, I also believe that when we allow Jesus to come and live in our hearts, that we will become agents of His peace on earth. And that if we have eyes to see it, we can see that God is already at work in this world in many ways and in many places promoting peace on earth. And you and I have the wonderful privilege of being used by God to become agents of His peace on this earth, so that wherever we go, we can spread peace on earth this holiday season.
Sing we know well, we know well, we hear our grace.
Please join me in singing Go Tell It on the Mountain.
Psalm 47:1 says, "Oh, clap your hands, O ye people, and shout unto God with the voice of triumph." And Ogoni Funaluwa is a Nigerian song that celebrates the coming of the Messiah. And this song actually echoes the command for us to sing to the Lord, to shout to the Lord, because he is a mighty God, he's mighty to save, and we serve a terrible God. The choir starts out by singing the theme, which is, "Iyo, iyo, ogoni funaluwa," and it means rejoice, rejoice, glory to God in the highest.
Oh, Mary, did you know? We're going to have prayer in just a moment, but before we do that, we wanted to say something. A lot goes into a program like this. On behalf of the Beltsville Adventist School Home and School, I'd like to thank everyone who gave their time and talent to make this program a success and a blessing for those of us who are here. Thank you to the teachers, the parents, the students, everyone that's here, the church. We especially want to thank Mrs. Thevenin. It's not easy. It's not an easy feat to teach more than 200 children to sing in a choir, to perform with the bells, to perform in an orchestra. So on behalf of the Home and School, we'd like to thank you and give you these flowers if you could come over.
Please bow your heads for the benediction. Our most kind, loving Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful Sabbath day. Thank you for letting all the participants in this program do their parts well. We pray that you would be with us as we depart from here and go our separate ways. Please be with us and help us as we learn to share your good news of your birth and your second coming. For our prayer in Christ's name, amen.